What's up, guys? It's Chris, and welcome back to My Corvette Life. It's kind of a bittersweet day today, a day that I kind of knew was coming for a while. I've sold the Callaway. I just don't have time for it. It's been sitting here for a year, and I haven't touched it at all. I know what the comments are going to say. They're not going to be pretty. I'm sure a lot of you won't be kind to me, but I'm sure a lot of you understand and are reasonable people. But I've just had other things in my life that I enjoy utilizing my time for better than working on cars now. I've kind of fallen out of the YouTube game. I'm busy with my kid and my other hobbies and work, and I'm okay with that. You know, I started this YouTube thing. It was fun for me back in the day when I was working on this car. This car is not going anywhere anytime soon. But you know, within the past couple of years, it's been more of a chore and more of a I have to do this to get followers, and that's not what I ever intended this to be for. So I'm done. I am a little sad that I didn't see the Callaway all the way through, but like I said, I just didn't have time. But the good news is it's going to somebody who owns a Callaway. I think he might own several, and he's okay with fixing it up, and it's going off to a good home, somebody who's knowledgeable about it and has resources that I don't. So it'll be in good hands, and hopefully we'll see it complete. Ready to go. Gone. All right, so about a week has gone by since I sold the Callaway, and a few things have happened. I got a new truck, so I'm going to show you that in a second. Timing was everything with this particular circumstance. As you guys probably know, I had a Colorado ZR2. It was a 2018. I bought it 3 years ago for $32,000. And just because of the way the market is right now with cars and trucks, I put 40,000 miles on that thing. It had 52,000 miles on it when I traded it in. And I traded it in for $32,000. Same price that I bought it for 3 years ago. So that was probably one of the best financial decisions I've made in my life. It just was pure luck, just the way the market is right now. But I got a new truck, so let's check it out. So this is my new, to me, 2021 Chevy Silverado 1500 Trail Boss. I loved my ZR2. I just didn't quite off-road as much as I thought I would. I did take it a few times and it was a lot of fun, but that truck is really good at off-roading stuff and I'm just utilizing it on the street 99% of the time. So, and I needed a bigger truck anyways. Now that I got the kid and I'm go-karting, I can fit the go-kart in the back of the bed. It really didn't fit in the Colorado at all. So this is going to be good for me. And with a little bit extra from the sale of the Callaway, I was able to pick this thing up. No payments at all, free and clear. matches the C5, so that's a bonus. All right, so we're a few days later and I've already got some changes to the truck, so let's take a look. Just installed these Rough Country running boards. They look pretty nice. I could have done without them myself, but the wife and some of my other family had a hard enough time getting into the Colorado, so I went ahead and got these installed. Should make it pretty easy. Even my 4-year-old daughter can get in the truck by herself now. I also installed this Rough Country storage bin underneath the seats. Can fit all my tools and stuff for work under there without it sliding around all over the place, so that's pretty cool. I also ordered a Corsa cold air intake, and I'm debating on getting a Corsa exhaust for the truck. It's so quiet, you can't hear it at all other than cold starts from the outside, but inside cruising around, you can't hear anything. You might as well be riding in a limousine, but debating on that. It's about $1,700-$1,800, which isn't terrible, but I'm just debating on whether I want to do that or not. I've heard that at cruising speeds you can't hear it at all, which is good, but you know, when you get on the throttle you can hear the nice sound. So debating on that, we'll see. What do you guys think? I pretty much already know what you guys think, so that is it for now. Other than that, I've been go-karting a lot. You can see I got my primary cart here, shifter cart on the bottom. This is my original go-kart that we're probably gonna put a slower 4-stroke motor on it just so some of our friends can play around with it. But this is my primary 2-stroke cart. It does about 75 miles an hour. The shifter will do 100. Our local track, we can get up to about 85-ish on it. Maybe just under that, but this has been a lot of fun. This has been taking up all my time. My friend's son actually races on the pro tour nationally, so I've been doing a lot with him, developing his skills. We were just at a race in Utah. They're going to North Carolina in 2 weeks, and then they're going to Indianapolis in about a month, so they're doing a lot of traveling races. He's in the top 20 in the nation. So he's doing pretty well. So that's where most of my time has been. It's been a lot of fun. Trust me, this is not like going to K1 or some indoor go-karting thing. These things will pull 2.5 G's on the track and go really fast. So more fun than any car I've ever driven. So, and more fun than working on cars. So that's where all my time has been. So hope you guys enjoyed this short little video of what I've been up to recently. I have no idea when I'm going to post again. I'm not going to be posting regularly, that's for sure. But whenever something comes up that I feel like posting about, I'll post. So we'll see you guys around. And if you want to check on what I'm doing in the meantime, I'm active on Instagram still. So go ahead and check that. I post just about daily or every other day of what's going on. So yeah, we'll see you guys around. Take care.